starry night. Flaming flowers that brightly blaze, swirling clouds in violet haze.
When I first started coming to the Verde Valley many, many years ago, one of the many things that was absolutely amazing to me was how many more stars there are up here. Well, we all know there aren't really any more stars here than there are in Phoenix, but the night skies, the dark skies, make it so much easier to view them. In fact, therein lies the reason for the glasses. We can even view our big star. We are here with JD Maddy, and we are going to talk about Astro Verde, the astronomy club here in the Verde Valley.
Oh, thank you.
JD, thanks for meeting with us.
Pleasure for you to be here. Just one precaution about viewing the sun. At nighttime, we don't have much of a problem with burning our eyes with the starlight, but whenever you view the sun, be sure to wear proper solar eyewear protection, such as these eclipse viewing glasses, or properly outfitted telescopes with proper solar filters.
And I will attest to the fact that there is absolutely nothing you can see except for the sun when you're wearing those glasses, so that helps out a little bit. You have been involved with gazing at all of the stars and the night skies and the daytime skies for many years. What got you interested?
Well, it was actually Sputnik, when the Russians launched Sputnik back in 1959. It was just really neat to go out at nighttime and watch that thing traverse across the sky as a moving star, and it basically captured my interest ever since.
I actually named a dog Sputnik when that came out, because I was so fascinated with all of it. So have you been in the Verde Valley all of this time?
No, we've moved to the Verde Valley about 12 years ago, and one of the reasons was the dark skies. We just love it up here. You can see that the Milky Way just really looks like a rain cloud as it moves across the sky at night. So we really enjoy looking at stars. And as well, you can see, we've kind of went overkill with the telescopes. We like it so much.
Well, it seems fascinating. I've seen many of the pictures that you've posted on the website, and it's absolutely amazing the level of detail that you can see. Again, even viewing with the naked eye, the stars are absolutely amazing, and you can see so much more here, but the pictures just give it that much more meaning and add that much interest for those of us that might be toying with the idea but might want to learn more. So tell me a little bit about the club and what your goals are as far as those of us that may be interested in finding out.
Well, our club is the Astronomers of Verde Valley, and we're located here, and we basically cater to people all over the Verde Valley. We even actually have some members that have part-time residences up here that live in Phoenix. So we cover a wide area. One of our primary interest is community outreach, doing star parties at night, solar gazing in the daytime and such. As we have set up here, we have two solar telescopes set up here. One dedicated hydrogen alpha telescopes that allows you to see flares, prominences, and some very nice detail on the surface of the sun. And then we have a regular nighttime telescope outfitted with just a glass solar filter that blocks out all the harmful infrared ultraviolet radiation, only allows just a very, very small percentage of the visual light to come through it, but we're able to see sunspots with that particular telescope.
So are these telescopes for daytime use only?
This one is, the hydrogen alpha telescopes for daytime only, but you can take a normal nighttime telescope and put a solar filter on it, and you'll have a solar telescope there.
You were telling me earlier that today the solar flares are very active?
Correct. We're entering about midpoint on the solar cycle, which is when the flares and the solar activity and the 2 weeks ago, you may recall, we had a coronal mass ejection that affected some satellites and air traffic and such. And over the next 2 years, that cycle is going to peak, and there will be more and more activity.
In all of the research that gets done with that, is this something that's going to continue to increase? Is it something that just a cycle?
Over the next 2 years, yes. And then this cycle will start decreasing over the 11 years. So there's a midpoint at roughly five and a half years in that 11-year solar cycle.
Wow, that's pretty amazing. So let's step back here just a little bit. So with this one, we can see the solar flares. Is
correct.
That what I understand?
Correct, yes.
Okay.
The solar flares are the plasma and such that come off the edge of the sun. And beings that this telescope only sees in hydrogen alpha wavelength, the sun appears very, very red. but it allows you to see those flares and prominences. And we have two particular prominences today that are probably over 50,000 miles tall, much, much larger than the Earth.
Well, maybe with any luck, we'll get a chance to take a look at that or some pictures of it as they happen. So
yes.
We'll look forward to that.
Yes.
A little bit more about the club. I know that you had an event last night, and you have monthly meetings.
Correct. Uh-huh.
Some of the highlights throughout the year, what would you say are the highlights?
For Verde River Days, we'll be at Verde River Days this year.
Oh, good.
And we'll have solar telescopes set up, basically these telescopes set up during the day to see the flares and prominences and sunspots and such. And then that evening, we'll have a star party with regular nighttime telescopes. But if you go to our website, astroverde.org, we have a list of upcoming events. And then if you click on the link, it'll give you the full year's events. We have quite a few events scheduled throughout the year.
I was looking at the schedule. It's very busy. It seems like at least once a month, if not two or three times a
yes,
month,
exactly.
there are events. And one thing, again, just a reminder, viewing the skies is as much fun during the daytime as it is at night, but you'd have a great experience by being out joining one of the star parties. And I know there are several right here in the Verde Valley, but you also go to some other locations. I believe Karchner Caverns.
Correct. Yes, we just
recently
returned from Karchner Caverns a couple of weeks ago. We had already had a star party at Lake Roosevelt this year. One of our largest events this year will be at Alamo Lake. Now that's a little ways from the Verde Valley, but that star party, this will be our sixth annual Alamo Lake Star Party in what they call Night Under the Stars, but it has been designated as an Arizona Centennial event.
Well, I'll want to keep that in mind. The opportunities are pretty endless, and I know we were talking earlier, I've had interest in the skies, but I've never actually gotten to the point where I've attended any of these. Definitely something that, even when I mentioned it to my husband, he wants to do. Check out the website, astroverde.org.
Correct.
And see what events are coming up. Attend a meeting at VVMC.
Yes.
People can check it out a little bit before they decide
sure
to join, I'm
yeah
assuming.
Yeah, the public's welcome to attend any of our meetings.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Check it out, and we'll join you back in the studios in just a few minutes.
I saw the sun is a big ball of gas, and it's 99% of our solar system's mass. It's an average star in our Milky Way, warming the Earth every day. What powers our sun and makes it so bright?